سؤال بخصوص اللقاء أو أي موضوع. أوكي، سو أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. Glory be to you. We have no knowledge except what you have taught us. Verily it is you, the all-knowing, the all-wise. Dear students of Semantics and Toxicology course, welcome to our new lecture. It is lecture number 11, and it focuses on sentential semantics or sentential meaning. So we talked about this topic earlier in lecture 9, but we have something additional, something interested, hopefully, inshallah. So the outline of our lecture, as usual, we have questions and comments, if you have any. The topics to discuss, we have sentence sense, sentence reference, and the truth conditions. We have paraphrase, we have entailment, contradiction, events versus states sentences. So eventive versus stative sentences. And finally, in the second half of our lecture, we have four presentations. Inshallah, they will be informative, and I wish the presenters all the best, inshallah. Questions? Questions? Tafadhal.
Could you please let some students in? They are waiting in the waiting room.
Thank you for telling me. So I welcome them. So be you all. So admit all. أهلا وسهلا بالجميع مرة تانية. Okay.
Thank you.
Guys, questions, comments, problems. طبعا ندعو للأخ عماد بالشفاء العاجل إن شاء الله. اللهم شفاء لا يغادر سقما بإذنه تعالى إن شاء الله. هو مرضى المسلمين إن شاء الله.
إن شاء الله آمين.
Questions guys. أي استفسار، أي سؤال. As you know, we are going to finish file 9. Last time we talked about thematic roles or theta roles, and we learned some information about the different roles noun phrases take in a sentence with relation to the verb in the sentence. Agent, theme, experiencer, cause, locative, source, goal, and so on, possessor, and so on. Questions? Okay, so I sent you some questions to reflect upon while you read the material, the rest of file 9. So the principle of compositionality is discussed again here in this second half of file 9. So who can tell me the definition or a simple definition of the principle of compositionality, which we, I think, studied in lecture 9, I think. Who can do that? So what do you mean by the principle of compositionality?
Yes, doctor.
Go ahead, Israel Kord.
Yes, it's me. The principle of compositionality means that the meaning of the sentence is built in part from the meaning of noun phrase and verb phrase.
So if we want to understand the sentence, the meaning of a sentence.
Yes, we have to understand the meaning of the phrase.
We should know the meanings of the words in the sentence and how they are combined together. So there are certain rules that govern the structure of a sentence or the structure of a phrase. So when we study or talk about the principle of compositionality, we would we refer to two things: the meanings of words and the meanings of
the relations of the
combination, sentence. How the words are combined in the sentence or the phrase. Now, in the second half of 5.9, we have something similar to what we studied about the principle of compositionality. It talks about now the noun phrase and the verb phrase in a sentence. So a sentence normally has a noun phrase and a verb phrase. And you remember when we said a subject, last time we talked about the first NP under S. So the noun phrase diagram in our material, the noun phrase as the subject, and then the predicate or the verb phrase, which includes also words, their meanings, and how they are combined, and what rules govern such combinations. So once again, we have a principle of compositionality. So let's think of this sentence. The old woman cooked the food yesterday. So it's a well-formed sentence, and it follows the principle of compositionality. We have words with meanings, and we have words combined in a certain pattern. We have the old woman as the subject, the old woman as the subject or the noun phrase. So sentence, we have noun phrase, and we have a verb phrase. And you can see so it's not a matter of how many words. So the subject here is a three words, but it could be one word, like Mona cooked the food yesterday, or she cooked the food yesterday, or just two words. So the woman cooked the food yesterday. So it's not a matter of number of words, but how they are combined within rules or according to rules. Now, the word yesterday here in the sentence is part of the verb phrase. And you can see still this word
modify the sentence.
Gives some information about or adds, qualifies or adds some information about the meaning of the sentence, especially the time of cooking food by the woman. So the woman's cooking of food. So it was yesterday. So it has this idea of time information added to the action or the event, which is cooking the food. Okay, so what is the sentence, a sentence sense or sense of a sentence? What
yes, doctor. Abdullah, doctor.
Yes, doctor.
Let's have.
Yes, doctor.
Ziad.
Yes, doctor. A sentence sense is, yes, a sentence sense, we mean by that what we refer to when we talk about the meaning of sentence.
Be careful, Abu Tariq. So when we talk about sense, in 2 weeks ago, we talked about the meaning.
Meaning, yes.
Not what the reference. So be careful. There are two things. We have sense and reference. Sense and reference. And
focus on the meaning.
So when we say, for example, the president of the United States of America, the sense is the meaning of this phrase. But now the reference, we talk about now a certain entity.
These days more than one reference.
So we have difference between sense and reference, or intension and extension. So it's not what it refers to, but just the meaning. Without thinking of the reference. The reference is something different. And last time, or 2 weeks ago, we learned that sometimes a phrase has a sense and a reference. Sometimes a phrase has a sense without a reference. And sometimes a phrase has a sense that is enduring, but its reference is not enduring. It's changeable over time. And this idea of the changing over time is exemplified by the president of the United States, or the president of Palestine, or the headmaster of a school X or Y. So we have now a sense and reference, and these are two different entities. When we talk about now a sentence sense, we talk about its meaning. And some language, so what is sentence sense? Again, the meaning. And so like what happens when we discuss noun phrases, we learn that noun phrases have meanings, because again, we study semantics, we study meaning, and we can say that this phrase makes sense, so it has meaning. But again, it is totally different from reference. So like noun phrases, sentences have sense or intention. And as you see here, the word...
معلش دكتور لو أقطعك بس في طالبة بتطلب من حضرتك تقبلها.
أهلا وسهلا. So tell her to leave the program and rejoin us, because I think I can't see anybody waiting. So هديل...
لا دخلت.
أهلا وسهلا.
جيت أتوى.
So be careful about the spelling of intention. Now, intention to mean sense is spelled this way. But when we have intention, niyya, it is totally different. So as a linguistic term, intention with this spelling means the sense, the meaning, without considering the reference. Okay.
تمام.
Yes, doctor.
Now, sentence reference, some linguists also think that sentences or certain sentences have reference.
Yes, doctor.
Go ahead.
A sentence reference or extension, the piece of information that tells whether the sentence can be true or false.
Yes, very good. So when we talk about now the truth of a sentence, whether the sentence is a truth, is it true or false? So the truth or falsehood of a sentence. So is what we mean by sentence reference. So some sentences are true, others are false, depending again on what. So we need to think of the circumstances, the conditions that tell us to know whether the sentence is true or false. So how do we know the truth of a sentence? We know the truth of a sentence by considering the circumstances under, or the conditions under which the sentence is said or spoken. So what does the term truth conditions mean? We talk about now the circumstances. Circumstances, so for example, if we say, Hadil came late. So we started our lecture about 15 minutes ago, and just 2 or 3 minutes ago, Hadil came. So considering the circumstances of or the conditions under which the sentence was said or spoken, we can tell whether now the sentence is true or false. So the truth conditions, the circumstances. So the sense of, so permitting you to know under what circumstances that sentence is true or false. The truth or falsehood. The truth or falsehood. So the truth conditions are the circumstances. The circumstances. Now, what is what do you mean by sentence or phrase? We discussed this before, by the way, and we gave
yes, Dr. Sentence paraphrase
definition. So when we have two sentences as paraphrases, we earlier yes, said that they mean.
Yes, doctor.
So Hadil, so what do you mean? Think of what we studied before. So two sentences as paraphrases are.
They have the semantic meaning, but they have made different in syntax.
So
same meaning, but different in style or different in syntax. Can I answer?
In fact, we have two types of
paraphrasing.
So we have two types of or two main types of paraphrasing. We have lexical paraphrasing and structural or syntactic paraphrasing. Now, we cannot just leave the semantic, the lexical paraphrasing hadil. So, not necessary to have different structure. We may have the same structure, but we have synonymy or two words with the same meaning, resulting in two sentences with the same meaning. So, lexical paraphrasing, like this room is bright, or this room is big, and this room is large, or I am happy to have met you, or I am pleased to have met you, or something like this. So, but again, paraphrasing
yes,
can be defined differently, or can be thought of.
Yes, doctor.
Yes, doctor.
Yes, means two sentences, paraphrases, they have the same true conditions.
So when they have the same truth or conditions, they are
paraphrases.
So if one is true, the other is true. If one is false, the other is false. So this is another way to think of the term paraphrase. So two sentences as paraphrases are sentences with the same truth condition, whether now both are true or both are false. So again, when we talk about truth conditions, we talk about the circumstances and the conditions are required to for this combination of sentence or words in the sentence. So this means whenever one is true, the other is true. And when one is false, the other is false, without exception. If we want to think of paraphrasing as having the same meaning, no exception to this idea of truth condition, conditions available, or the same truth conditions available in both sentences. Let's consider a special type of, or one main type of paraphrasing, structural paraphrasing, discussing active and passive. Again, we talked about how lexic structural paraphrasing is exemplified in passive and active. So why? You remember when we said we have two different structures, but again, the noun phrases function or have or play the same function or have the same semantic roles or theta roles, if you remember. So the horse, room, the rider, we have two noun phrases put together in a sentence related to a verb through. So, and then we have another sentence the rider was thrown by the horse, and this is the passive of the past. So number two is the passive of the past, and it has the same meaning or almost the same meaning. By the way, we can find some a little difference in emphasis. Now the writer is now or is focused on. So when we emphasize or when we focus on the receiver of the action, we put it in the front as a subject of the passive sentence. But again, we have two sentences structurally different, but semantically the same. Semantically, they are paraphrases, having the same truth conditions, having noun phrases are playing the same semantic roles or functioning the same semantic roles. Question. Now, my question, which I sent to you, are all.
Yes, doctor.
Doctor.
Doctor Abdullah.
Yes, yes, doctor.
Yes.
Abdullah, doctor.
So please, Fatin Hussein. Go ahead, Fatin Hussein.
Active and passive actually are considered as structural paraphrases, and they have sometimes the same meaning, but with little, you know, the emphasis or the sense of emphasis is different from one sentence to another.
This can be considered as paraphrasing the same. So they still, we can say that sentences one and two are of the same meaning. 99% or 98%, I mean, the same meaning, and they are considered paraphrases as an example of syntactic or structural paraphrase. But again, the question is, are all active and passive pairs?
Not always. Sometimes, yes, not always. Sometimes when we add quantities like always or few, we can't consider active and passive the same meaning.
So when we have quantifiers, you mean? So few, each, many, several, every. Yes. These are called the quantifiers or expressions of a quantity. And sometimes by having active and passive pair, the result is not of the same meaning. So example, let's have these two sentences as an example. In fact, they involve pacifization. So every person in this room speaks two languages. This is active. Two languages are spoken by every person in this room. This is passive.
Passive. Can I clarify?
Number two is the passive of number one. But
there's a slight difference.
Paraphrases? The student who said there is a slight difference. In fact, there is a big difference. And they are not paraphrases. Why? Because now the second sentence is totally different in meaning. Totally different from number one. So let's have Aida Darwish. So Aida, is Aida here?
Doctor Khadina.
So Abir Abu Jana.
Yes, doctor.
So now
دكتور بعد إذن حضرتك في طالبة اسمها غدا الرزي بعت رسالة إنه الإنترنت خلص اشتراكه الآن وبتعتذر يعني الآن تفاجأت بالاشتراك يعني
نعذر الجميع نلتمس العذر لها so but if she can get an access to the internet and join us it would be much better so
I'll inform her
buy a ticket for one shekel to have access to the internet. Anyway, so we have about 1 hour, 2 hour. Yeah. So still you can find a way to join us later, Ghada. Okay. Thank you very much, Abdullah. Now, how are these two sentences different in meaning? Why are they not appropriate for Amir Abu Jahl?
Yes, doctor.
Well.
Okay, the two sentences here don't have the same truth conditions, so they are not paraphrase.
So, give me just a real example. So, if we have, for example, three people in the room, 1, 2, 3. Now, a room with three people. And now, according to number one, according to sentence number one, every person in this room speaks two languages. Let's have this truth condition or the circumstances. Number one speaks language A and language B. Samum et samum. And so person two speaks sentence language C and language D. And person number three speaks language E and language F. You can give example names to these languages. So Arabic, Japanese, English, Chinese, French, Vietnamese, so whatever. Now is a sentence one, so truth. So 1, 2, 3. So according to this diagram, sentence one is a true. So the circumstances given, we can see that each of these people, each of the three people, speaks two languages. كل واحد منهم بيتكلم لغتين. Now, what about sentence two?
Yes, doctor.
Yes.
Yes,
two languages are spoken by every person in this room.
Specific two languages.
We cannot find two languages spoken by every person. حتى لو كان هنا مثلا يقول Arabic and let's say Hebrew, Arabic and Hebrew. خلينا نقول مثلا حتى لو غيرت مثلا Arabic and Hebrew, and here we have Hebrew and Dutch مثلا and here English and French. Although we have Hebrew spoken by two people, so one and two, but still two languages are spoken by every person, so not the same two languages. So not the same two languages are spoken by every person in this room. That's why now the truth of sentence two is not the same as the truth of sentence one. That's why they are not paraphrases. So the addition of the quantifier every results in no paraphrasing when we have active and passive. Clear? Question. Would you like me to repeat? في مثال حي في كتابك. So we have three people with names and each speaks two languages. So making sentence one, okay. But now, what about sentence two? When we passivize it, does it have the same meaning of one? No, if we do it divide. لكن ممكن تكون هيك. So three people, each speaks the same two languages, but it's not necessary. So every person in this room speaks two languages, it could be again as we did. So A, B, C, D, E, F. So no two languages are spoken by every person in this room. That's why active and passive pairs are not always or result or don't always result in paraphrasing. Don't always give the same meaning. So sentence two is totally different from sentence one in meaning. So we don't have now paraphrasing. More examples of structural paraphrasing. We have these structures. So
we have different sentences.
Four sentences, and they can be considered as structural paraphrases in a way or another. So the structure is not the same, but the meaning is almost the same or the same. Now, why is the meaning of all these sentences the same, or the meaning of each? Sameness or paraphrasing. Why? Because you remember we talked about the thematic roles. Each of these sentences have with the same semantic roles or theta roles, resulting in, again, or if you can talk about now truth. So sentence one has the same truth conditions or the same circumstances. It is easy. So talking about the easiness. To play sonatas on this piano. You see, now this piano is easy to play sonatas on. On this piano, we need a comma. It is easy to play sonatas. And sonatas are easy to play on this piano. What happens here? We have different structures. How do we have different structures? You remember this school of linguistics, the transformational and generative grammar or model of linguistics. Transformational grammar. So we have a transformational rules applied to the deep structure to have a different structure through, again, transformational rules. We can name the transformational rule, but we don't need it now. Again, we have rules that result in a different structure, but still the meaning is kept or is still the same. More examples, we have Booth assassinated Lincoln, or it was Booth who assassinated Lincoln. So sometimes it is called the Clift transformational, this idea of transformational rule. Clift transformation rule, C-L-E-F-T, Clift. Transformation. Anyway, not necessary to know the term. So again, number five and number six are structurally paraphrases or have the same meaning. Why? Again, because we have noun phrases in both sentences playing the same semantic roles or having the same semantic or theta roles or the same semantic functions. More examples. Number seven. More example. Number eight. So eight, five, six, seven, eight have the same meaning, although they differ in structure. A different way of having structural paraphrase is the students gave money to the bigger. The students gave the bigger money. Moving us a certain part. And you can see the difference between 9 and 10. In 9, we have money as the direct object of the verb give. But now to the bigger, now the second object is in a prepositional phrase. But in sentence 10, the structure has gave with two objects, the indirect object and the direct object. Still, we have the same meaning. Still, we have paraphrasing. Why? Again, because we have the same theta roles assigned to the noun phrases in both sentences. So students, as the subject playing the function of agent, and we have gave, and then we have money, and we have bigger. So we have here like the goal of giving. Question. More examples of structural paraphrasing. We have this pairs. So to express ability, we can use this column. To express permission, we can use this or use this. To express obligation, either this or this. What happens here? Your material says that this column has auxiliaries. And this column has no auxiliaries. So with auxiliaries, without auxiliaries, this is what your material says. Although some grammar books consider be able to and be obliged to and so on as a phrasal models, but still, so it is a different structure. In a way or another, whether it is a real model or auxiliary or not, still we have different structures. To have a single word as an auxiliary or a whole phrase is able to and so on.
Doctor, can I ask a question?
Question. Fadal.
Can we consider a hat bitter as an auxiliary or, let's say, modal phrase?
Which one?
Hat bitter. Means
in
must.
In fact, this is a nice question. And since you are teachers, or most of you are teachers, I feel that it is important to talk about this point. And let's have some digression, استطراد, ونرجع للموضوع بتاعنا. So, as you remember, when we talked about lexical categories or parts of speech, we said that we have verbs, we have nouns, we have adjectives, and we have adverbs and so on. But we also talked about subcategorization. So we said that we have verbs that can be transitive or intransitive and so on. And nouns can be countable and non-countable and so on. And we can also talk about verbs in a different way. So we can talk about verbs as main verbs and helping verbs or auxiliaries. So this is also a possible way of a classification. Now, auxiliaries, so main verbs are like eat or drink or walk or smell and so on. These are main verbs. They are lexical verbs. They have, but verbs can also be auxiliaries or helping. Now, auxiliaries can also be sub-classified. Auxiliaries can be either primary auxiliaries or modal auxiliaries. So primary and modal. And primary auxiliaries are either a verb to be or verb to have or verb to do. Be careful. When we say be, we have am, is, are, was, where, and so on. Have, has, had. Do, does, did. Do we have done as a primary auxiliary?
No.
No. So done, done, the past participle is not an auxiliary. It's a main verb.
Main verb.
It's a main verb. Because when I say, I have done the exercise, have is an auxiliary. I have done the exercise. But done is a main verb. But the verb do can be an auxiliary. When you use it for negation, I don't like spaghetti. I didn't go to the museum. She doesn't speak French. So now for negation. We can also use verb to do for questions. Do you play football or do you like apples or and so on? We can also use a verb to do as an auxiliary for as emphatic. I do love teaching. Also, you see what I mean by emphatic? So it is to emphasize an auxiliary and so on. But again, done is never used as an auxiliary. So be careful. Now, modal auxiliaries can be either basic or phrasal. Basic or phrasal. Now, basic models are واللي حكت من ضمنهم. So نسمع مع بعض. Shall, should, will, would, can, could, may, might, must, ought to, and had, better. أشياءهم 11. So shall, should, will, would, can, could, may, might, must, ought to, and had better, 11. So all these are basic models. We have phrasal models. If you check grammar books, phrasal, so basic models are shall, should, will, kamli. Now phrasal models, I think 6, or mainly 6. So we have be able to, be going to, be supposed to, be so have to, have got to, and used to. ممكن أضيف لهم be obliged to or be permitted to. So we have again the same idea of modal, but in a phrase. Is it available to what is now be able to? It's the same as can. So to express ability. Be going to is the same as will. So be supposed to is the same as should when it is for advisability. Have to, it's the same as what? As must. And have to for obligation. Used to is for now, for habit in the past.
Auto, where can we put it?
No,
basic or phrasal auto?
It is. Shall, should, will, would. Can, could. May, might, must, ought to. Because ought to is not a phrase because sometimes we omit all. And we can have something here. So ought not. So it's different from it's different from this phrase. So
Doctor, actually ought it is ought, not ought to, but ought is added to it to add a verb. It is ought.
So, and something, may I make a comment, doctor?
Yeah, go ahead. So
I guess there is a slight...
Ought to different is different from have to. And it's different from used to. Mm. Okay.
But about have to and must, one of our lecturers...
This is a question. I'm talking about the difference now between...
الحلو يا دكتور انك بتعرف قبل المساله يعني
عارف ايش بدك تقول
ماست ليش اعتبرنا انه هاد بيتر بيسك موديل مع انها انه مبينه فريز يعني وما فينا نحذف البيتر مثلا
سؤالك وجه هنا طبعا هنا لازم ال11 هاد بيتر This is how I learn. So had better, ممكن you can check. But again, had better is a modal auxiliary. It is followed by base form of the verb. Is an had better go. So don't say had now is part of the verb to have here. So it's totally different. So there is no relation between had here and have has had here. So she had done the exercise before she went to bed. But you had better do the exercise. You had better study for the exam. You had better prepare for the lecture. You had better. So advisability.
It's not changed.
Advisability. طبعاً عبد الله كان بيسأل عن the difference between must and have to. We have some difference. طبعاً بذكر الله يمسيه بالخير الأستاذ أبو الوليد إبراهيم الوليد بعرفش إذا بتسمعوا فيه أستاذ فاضل في مدرسة كان إحنا على الهواء بنمسي عليه إذا كان يعني سمعت الله العايش الله يديله الصحة كنت بشتغل في مدرسة ممدوح صيدم اللي هي مدرسة خالد بن الوليد بنال بنكمل حدوته في النص الثاني من اللقاء عشان خصوصية اللقاء. Okay. Thank you very much. So again, we have more examples of structural paraphrasing using this pattern for this pattern. So again, this is the same meaning. That's why we have paraphrasing. This is the same meaning. So this is the same meaning. So we have a same meaning, same meaning. So it's but they are different structure. That's why we say structural paraphrasing. Question. Now, more examples. We may have one word changed into a phrase, if you remember. So John saw Mary, John perceived Mary using his eyes. Not common, but again, it gives this idea. استعمل عيني أو شاف حسب Mary من خلال عينيه. So John perceived Mary using his eyes. What happens here? We have the word, the verb, so changed into a whole phrase. Perceiving someone by using a soil. Or so to perceive using eyes is like the phrase instead of the verb. So we have difference in structure.
بعد إذنك دكتور لو تقبل في أحد الزملاء.
أهلا وسهلا.
دكتور معلش سؤال ثاني.
دخل الأخ اللي دخل متأخر. Okay. So the same idea here. We have a different way of paraphrasing, structural paraphrasing, a different pattern. One word replaced or substituted by a whole phrase or a group of words.
دكتور ممكن سؤال؟
تفضل.
أنا صراحة هاي استوقفتني وأنا بقرأ بالارتكل. طب الآن مش two sentences here have the same structure like subject and then verb.
No.
ليه ما اعتبرناها أنه lexical paraphrasing على أساس أنه إحنا عملنا substitution للverb so.
حلو كلام. I love it. I wonderful question. Now be careful.
But because we add some information, doctor.
Please. Thank you very much. When I ask you, Abdullah, you can. So here we have one wonderful point. Talking about the same structure. مين اللي حكت؟ الأخت اللي حكت؟ فاتح. سؤالك جميل بل جميل جدا. So now when we say the same structure, it should be the same structure. Subject, verb, object. But now, is it the same structure?
We start with subject and then verb and complement.
We have now a subject, verb, then object. Then we're using now, we have like something additional. So again, now the means. So how to perceive? فاكرين يعني the means used to, you see here? So he wrote a letter using a pencil. هتقولي لي he typed or he wrote a letter? No, it's different. So the structure is not the same. It could be similar, but we cannot consider it the same. So different structure, but still the same meaning. That's why we say structural paraphrasing. I like your question further.
And,
thank you. Sir. I don't hesitate to ask. Very good. Okay. So a third, another pair of sentences. We have the professor lectured the class. The professor delivered the lecture to the class. Delivered lecture to the class. You see what I mean by now? One word. Changed or substituted by a whole group of words or phrase. So delivered a lecture to.
Excuse me, doctor.
Instead of the verb lecture. Fadal.
A question, يمكن هو silly question. يعني لما أنا بس no. changing no. just one no. word.
Silly, never. So yeah. I remember when I was in California, one of my professors said, sometimes the answer to a little question, not silly, the answer to a little question opens gates to knowledge. Go ahead.
Yes, doctor. When I use the professor lecture or whatever, just changing one word in the sentence. لما بغير بس كلمة واحدة هاد أنا بعتبر يعني لما بدي أدخل على التيرنت إن هل بتنكشف إنها مثلاً سرقة أو عادي يعني بس هاي سؤالي. إنه أنا دائماً بعمل بشكل بالجملة كلها صراحة. أنا لو بدي أغير.
جاوبنا يا دكتور.
يعني هذا
جاوبنا يا دكتور.
Now this.
وأنا بس بدي أسأل هذا السؤال إنه لما نغير
كلمة. This would help you in writing research later. So this structure, this topic, paraphrasing helps you in other courses or also in your academic writing.
طب ممكن أقول لهم آلية العمل؟
تفضل يا عبد الله إذا في معلومات عن تيرنتين.
آلية العمل التيرنتين اللي بحب يعرف آلية عمل التيرنتين هو بيفحص كل ثلاث كلمات وراء بعض. فكل ثلاث كلمات وراء بعض بيعتبرهم سرقة علمية. فإذا كان عندك تشابه بنسبة ثلاث كلمات في نفس الجملة سرقة علمية بالنسبة للتيرنتين.
معلومة كويسة. شكرا.
لو سمحت
A piece of advice. I think you can use a different structure, but still keep the meaning. Not necessary to replace words or to have synonym. This room is big. This room is large. I feel that still you can change the whole structure, but keep the meaning. To avoid this similarity issue of internet end or copy paste. وطبعا عندك 20% هتحسب الكلمتين والثلاثة ولا عشان كده الهامش 20%. But when it is long without quotation marks ورا بعضهم زي ما بقول عبد الله مش واحدة وتنتين وثلاثة. So a group of words may be the sentence without quotation marks.
كوبي بيست كمان حتى لو كمان 5% عند حسن النبي او اللي زي 5% ممنوع 2% so be careful مش 20% وعيني انا في السليم so when it is quoted so when you says quote someone without quotation marks and page number this is a plagiarism and it is illegal it is something wrong سو مش عشان انا 20% مسموح في الجامعه الاسلاميه ولا في المكان سو اجين within ethics within ethical rules so or guidelines to follow when you quote quotation marks with page number and if it is more than 40 words حسب ما تعلمته اكثر من 40 كلمه you start a new line with indentation and then the page number there so he says oh call it وبعد كده or she asked and if it is more than the 40 words تفضل هذا عنده استفسار او سؤال انا مبسوط من الاسئله يعني والمشاركات اللي تثير اللقاء thank you for your questions enrich our Don't hesitate to ask about anything.
أنا صراحة والله ما بستخدمها بس أحيانا واحد ممكن طرها في جملة واحدة بس هي هل يعني لو اضطرنا أنا بس هي كان السؤال.
Be careful, be careful. So the less the fewer the better. So the fewer quotations the better always. So try to paraphrase. Now when you paraphrase, still you need to give credit to the author of the idea or to the author of this concept. So It's not your idea, although you now write in your own words, but since it is not your own idea, so give credit to the author. فلان بيقول حتى لو غيرت الكلام بتاعه in paraphrasing, but still you give the credit بمعنى the author and the year.
دكتور ممكن احكي حاجه اسال سؤال بس عفوا دكتور يعني انا يعني كثير بنكتب ابحاث وبتخطر على بالك مثلا استنتاج معين وبعد من خلال ما انت قرات في استنتاج انت بتحط الاستنتاج وبعد ما تحطه هنا كلماتك وشغلك واستنتاجك بتكتشف انه في غيرك اصلا مستنتجه من قبلك فانت هيك بتضلك في نفس الدائره دائره اللصوصيه
لا لا, لا, لا لا ممكن يعني for this ممكن كلام بمنطق يعني my conclusion give support to fulan's work on lens for work or x and y and so on so to تكتشف واذا اكتشفت حقيقي so this makes your research more effective or stronger when you see my conclusions come in line with or go in line with conclusions of x y and z and so on. يتفق ما وصلت إليه مع ما وصل إليه الآخرين من الآخرون من و و و You see what I mean by go in line with support and so on. تفضل.
إنه الresults أو الdiscussion could be similar to other researches but still the context is different like if there is a research conducted in America
see,
and
when we have a study conducted in a different setting or context
yes.
and so we have some support to what was done before why not بالمناسبة كنت بقرأ الواجبات الواجب رقم 3 assignment 3 وفي طالبة كانت تقول يعني morphology is the study of meaning وعملالي الغريب كمان عملالي cited in فلان by فلان يعني عملت two authors author one author two والكل بيقولوا why it's something for granted لأن مسلمات يعني انت you can be cited والآن نقول الفواب So to say for example أحيانا I recommend as cited in مثلا Smith 1995 where حسب ما قال فلان الآن كان بيقول نقول مثلا جاكسون as cited in Jackson 2005 argues so blah 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 وبنقول as cited in Smith. This is not recommended to do. بنصحكش ولا بنصحك تسوي الحاجة هاي. I recommend you leave this. آسف هنا لازم يكون ترخيص. Jackson 1995 as cited in Smith 2005. أنت ما قرأتش ما قرأتش Jackson. أنت قرأت Smith وأخذت بكلامه. إنه قال إنه فلان قال وتكمل الفكرة. This is not ethical. It's recommended to go back to the first author, author one. إذا عجزت وهذا نادم الآن العلم موجود ومفتوح. And you can get any piece of paper or sorry, article or book. مش هتصعب عليك لو اذا صعبت ممكن تقول الكلام هذا لكن not recommended. كنت بناقش في رساله ماجستير ويمكن 50 مره as cited in ارحمينا as cited in كذا so please go to author one. افترضوا كذاب افترضوا ما حصلش منه افترض جاب كلام مش من so just to believe in what he قال كما قال سميث قال عن جاكسون وانت بتاخذي سميث تاخذي كلام جاكسون واللي وثقوا سميث.
طب دكتور احنا احيانا بنكون مطالبين انه يكون الستاديز ريسنت فانا لو بدي اروح على جاكسون مثلا فبيكون دراسته قديمه فانا بضطر اخذ الدراسه الحديثه.
خذي كلامه اللي له الخاص به اما ما انا بنسى بعدين لكن احيانا مش كل كلام قديم 1970 لا يعتد به
يا دكتور في بعض المسلمات اساسا زي تعريف كلتشر
لغايه اليوم سينتاكتيك ستراكشرز باي تشومسكي الكتاب الشهير اللي كان اصلا رساله الدكتوراه تبعته 1957 ليش لا واول ما طلع بالتي جي
ولو بدنا نعرف الكلتشر مثلا ما اللي عرفها يعني مات وشبع موت ما هو تعريف واحد
اوكي جريت سو جت ماي بوينت شكرا على يعني الاستطراد هذا والخروج عن يعني سياق لكن ات هيلبس ثانك يو فيري ماتش فور يور كويستشنز ستيل وي هاف سم تايم تو فينيش ذس بارت اوف فايل 9 بيفور هافينج ذا بريك اند صلاه and then the presentations. So let's move to entailment. So now you know what I mean by paraphrasing and how to paraphrase. To use now lexical paraphrasing or structural paraphrasing and how to paraphrase structurally or syntactically. Sorry, we have different ways. Again, depending on the transformational rule used. But still, we need to think of the theta roles assigned to the noun phrases in both sentences in order to have the same meaning. The same way. Now, when we talk about paraphrasing in academic research or scientific research, we don't talk about now sentences. We talk about maybe paragraphs or a whole so ideas, so things that are paraphrased in. Scientific research means that you take the idea, whether it is in one sentence, two sentences, three sentences, and then discuss it in your own words. But when we talk about sentence, نتكلم موضوعنا عنوان المحاضرة, sentential semantics or meaning. So we talk about sentences. A pair of sentences have the same meaning. Again, when they have the same truth conditions, or they have both are true, or both are false, or when the theta roles assigned to noun phrases in these two sentences are the same. Question: what do you mean by entailment?
دكتور؟
أنا يا دكتور النجوم.
ليتس بس
أمل أمل المفارز.
أو بليز بسمة.
أمل.
يس دكتور.
تفضل يا دكتور. تفضل.
يس انتمنت انتمنت مينز اند يس ميبي ذا سام تايمز نون ذا وان سنتنس
مش بيقطع بس انا مش سامع حاجه اذن اي كانت هير يو ويل سو ايذر يو
سامع انصر دكتور امل خير
سي ات اجين اور جيف ذا تشانس تو انذر ستودنت
عبد الله
Try it again. So please,
Basma.
Yes.
Give her a chance.
Can you hear me?
Repeat what you
have.
Repeat what you have.
Yes. Entailment means that sometimes it's known as or a truth of one sentence entails or implies the truth of another sentence.
So this idea of imply. So
yes.
If you say something, and then this implies something else. So we can, this else is so sentence one entails. So let's see. So
can I give an example, sir?
So we have a nice example in the material. So Tom assassinated Peter, and Peter is dead.
And
so which entails which? Which entails which? Which sentence entails which?
The first one entails the second.
The first one entails the second.
Excellent. So one entails the second. The first entails the second. So sometimes knowing the truth of one sentence entails
or implies
the second sentence.
The truth of another sentence. Both are true, but this truth of the two sentences involve this idea or concept of entailment as a semantic concept, relation among sentences. One sentence implied the idea stated in another sentence.
Can I ask, Doctor?
What's said?
Yes, can I ask?
Go ahead.
Yes, can we call the entailment like implicature? I remember in this course analysis, we have the term implicature. That when we say, let's go home, that means we are outside. Can we call this like this?
I need to go, I need to check before saying yes, but things sometimes are overlapping. And certain, some terminology sometimes varies with, from one reference to another or one...
May I answer?
Field of study to another. Go ahead.
Doctor, implications is when you say something and mean something else. It's just like when you say that it's cold here, you mean that please close the window. It is not just like, it is not like the entailments.
So there is some difference.
Yes.
بس أنا شايفه زياد خشان اللي بيتكلم.
بس دكتور زياد خشان برفع إيده وبنساها يا دكتور.
لا مظبوط اثنين زياد خشان مكتوب مظبوط.
لا انا بقول لك يا دكتور انا بالغلط دخلت من حسابه وما عرفتش اطلع لانه حسابه كان مسجل عندي
وانا هنا من اول الفصل بشوف زياد خشان ومش وسام
لا هو اليوم امبارح
يا عبد الله
لا اليوم امبارح والله دكتور اليوم امبارح يا دكتور انا عشان حسابه عندي بالغلط اصلا ابو طارق سامحني انا بالغلط والله
لا صاحب الحساب الحقيقي والغلطان
شكرا دكتور
okay so it is logically inconsistent for the former to be true and how to pronounce this word who can read it بالمناسبة so you need to say later not later So later, when we have now two things or entity or people, and when we say the former, so the first, the latter, الأول من الاثنين والثاني يعني الآخر. So when one is true, the second must be true. Otherwise, there is no such a thing called entailment. Entailment means that when there is a truth in one sentence, there is a truth in the second. So never to have a falsehood in one sentence and a truth in another. And say, and then consider that this isn't it. Now, for examples of entailment, the brick is red, and we say the brick is not white. Now, in a few minutes, we are going to talk about contradiction. To say the brick is red, the brick is not the brick is red, the brick is not red. So we have contradiction. But now, the brick is red, the brick is not white. We can imply that it is not white. So because now the circumstances, the truth conditions. So we are, this is the color of the brick. Now, so to say it's white, this is false.
Negation.
The idea of not here makes the sentence true. We managed to make it similar to the first and having this entailment. Not white. Mortimer is a bachelor and Mortimer is male. By the way, the word bachelor.
Single. He's not married.
Never married.
And never for a male.
A male.
For the male, yeah.
Spencer for the female.
يسبق له الزواج. So, رجل. So, a bachelor, a male who has never got, never got married. So, but the equivalent word for females.
Spinster.
Spinster also. This is not approved, by the way. So when we say a bachelor, we imply that this person is male. And we can think of now semantic properties and features, the stuff we talked about earlier. Let's move to contradiction. Contradiction, again, is the opposite of entailment. Now, you remember, entailment means both
have the same
must be true or false. But here, contradiction, we expect to have one as true and the second as false. So, the truth of one of these two sentences implies the falsehood or the falseness of the second. An example. Elizabeth II is Queen of England. So to say it, she is a man, this is contradiction. Now how come to have now queen with this? Now you remember semantic properties of words in the lexicon stored in your mental dictionary, these pieces of information. So queen has this semantic feature minus male. And now you see it's a man. This word has the feature plus male. So there is a contradiction between now the two sentences. Question?
Yes, excuse me, doctor.
Go ahead.
If we say, for example, Ali is a student or Ali is a teacher, can we consider them contradiction also?
Not necessarily, not necessarily. أنا عندي طلاب وهيني موجودين عندكم في طالب وبعد كده يكون معلم. Why not? So not necessary to have this idea of contradiction in pairs of sentences like these.
Yes.
But to see now, Hassan is a present and he is absent, we have contradiction. كيف يعني حاضر وغايب معنا لك كيف يعني؟ Unless you now have like some poetic effect والآن وندخل في الأنومالي اللي هتكون محاضرة المرة.
أنا حاضر بجسمه مش بالربع
هنتكلم على الكلام هذا anomaly, poetry, metaphors, idiomatic expressions هيكون محاضرة المرة اللقاء القادم إن شاء الله ويكون file number 10 إن شاء الله. Scott is a baby. Scott is an adult. يا سلام. Unless you have now this idea of imagery or poetic effect and so on.
Yeah,
but a baby, with this idea, so the simple, without adding some other or considering the poetic effect or imagery or aesthetic. So Scott is a baby, Scott is an adult, two sentences that involve contradiction. Now let's move to something interesting. Although it's, in fact, it's not difficult to read. ممكن أسيبه ويعتبر جزء من المسار والامتحانات ولكن it helps. Now we can talk about now verbs in terms of eventive and stative. So we have eventive verbs and stative verbs. So the verb, for example, eat or drink or cut or break or walk and so on are eventive verbs. But verbs like know or like or want or seem or so on, these are so we have stative verbs. So she likes spaghetti, or he knows my brother, and so on. So we have now stative verbs. Now using eventive verbs in sentences make the sentence eventive. And using stative verbs in sentences or clauses makes the sentence a stative sentence. Since we are talking about now not verbs, we talk about sentences. So including either eventive verbs or stative verbs. So some sentences describe events when they have eventive verbs, like played football. So John played football. Or Peter ate fish. Or Layla wrote a letter. Or Mona cooked the food and so on. We have also sentences that describe states. Example, John knows Mary. Or Peter likes fish and so on. These two, so these two pairs of sentences, one, two on one hand and three, four on the other, look similar in noun structure in terms of syntax. Subject, verb, object. Subject, verb, object. Subject, verb, object, and so on. But in terms of semantics, we have something now important to highlight. And this would lead us to talk about now the interaction, between semantics and syntax. We have interrelation. حيتقاطع علم التركيب مع علم الدلالة. How come? How are eventive sentences different from stative sentences? How are? بعت لك يا سؤال هذا بعت لك. طب How are eventive sentences? كلام eventive sentences معناتها sentences that describe events. Sentences that include eventive verbs. Now, stative sentences are sentences that describe states or sentences that include stative verbs or state verbs. Okay, now, how do they differ?
Yes, doctor. Yes, doctor.
Yes, doctor.
Yes, doctor.
Abdelkarim Al-Halabi.
Abdelkarim. Fadal Abdelkarim.
Yes, the stative verbs cannot appear in the present continuous, cannot be used in the progressive action. But the events can be used in the progressive
in
action.
Fact, our material, although it's simple, couple of pages,
yes,
it has some nice information.
Yes, doctor.
There are four differences.
Yes, doctor.
Four differences between eventive verbs and stative verbs, or eventive sentences and the stative sentences. What are they? Abdullah, تفضل يا عبدالله.
Yes, doctor, the first, the difference appear, the difference, mute, natural, natural, eventive sentences sound neutral when passivized.
So we can talk about the passive structure as one difference.
Yes, the first,
it is common to use eventive or to change active eventive sentences into passive eventive sentences. Okay.
Yes, doctor.
But not
when certain.
Okay.
Okay.
The second.
Yes, doctor.
Okay, زميلك وقال progressive. اديت لي الحاجتين التانيين. Give me the other two differences, Abdullah.
I just have one, which is I mentioned.
That's it. So we have now, as your friend said, we have passivization, passive structure. We have a progressive structure. And number three?
Yes, doctor.
Yes, doctor.
Yes, doctor.
Imperative.
Amal?
Imperative.
Ahmed Al-Farra? Fadal Ahmed.
Yes, doctor.
Fadal Ahmed.
Yes, when we used it imperatively.
So using the imperative. And you know what
yes,
the imperative? So
Amr.
So you starting with the base form, like for example, key. So we have stand up.
Study hard.
So study hard. Period. Or stand up. Period. Or open the door. These are called imperative. So sentences are of four types. We have declarative khabariya. Statements, we have interrogative istifhamiya questions, we have imperative talabiya commands, order, and we have exclamative or exclamatory ta'ajjubiya. Now, these are full sentences, yes. The subject of these sentences is implied, is understood. It is covert mustatir, but it is understood, it means you. You study hard, and you stand up, you open the door. So we have the subject hidden or invisible or covert. Now, it is common, it is so eventive sentences or eventive verbs are used in this structure, on this pattern. So play well, or study or stand and open. But stative verbs are not commonly used in imperative. كتابك عامل علامة استفهام بالمناسبة كما شو هنعرف. هاي هنا الأمثلة طبعا والنوع الرابع هاي هنا الأمثلة. هذه هنا علامات استفهام. شايف علامات استفهام هنا؟
Yes, doctor.
Strangeness هذه. لا
بكي لا. So we learned that in linguistics, we have certain conventions or traditions. So to use a star or an asterisk means that the sentence is ill-formed. Or
ill-formed.
Now, using a question mark means that the sentence is not natural.
Strange.
Or the sentence is strange. Or the sentence is
peculiar.
Used weird or not natural or anomalous. I am going to anomalous. تمام مش مألوف. وناس بتقول لك يعني تقترب من يعني الفورم تقترب من الخطأ. لكن يعني بالمناسبة since we are talking about the verb like الآن هذا الكلام is liking. ممكن نقول على بنعلمه لأولادنا في المدارس ونقول لهم this is ungrammatical. كتابنا هنا بيفيد معلومة مهمة. So let's say it's rare. عشان يكونوا يعني دقيقين. It's not natural. It's not common. It's very rare. عشان مش نقول يعني ungrammatical. يعني ممكن يا أبو أحمد تذكر لنا مثال على يعني situation where we use like in the progressive. I had this situation or this experience in this team. Once I was invited to a potluck party. In some ways, potluck party. What's يعني potluck party? مين بيعرف؟ عزومة وتاخد صحنك معاك.
زي البوفيه في مصر مثلا في العراس.
البوفيه يعني من
غديوة.
take something from home when you go to the party. بالبساطة هذه. So I cooked some special food, Palestinian one, مقلوبة. حبقى أبعث لكم الصورة تبعت. A big dish كده, and I wrote the ingredients on a piece of paper. طيب. The name of the dish, مقلوبة. And then the transliteration. And the meaning upside down, and then the ingredients, the المكونات ولا المقادير. When I went to the party, an American friend, طبعا كنا يعني international students, كنا معزومين by the international office, or office of international students, in California University. فكان الظريف يعني asked me about my dish, maqlouba, made of rice, lamb, and chickpeas, with hummus, with lamb. So one American friend started to eat from my dish. وطبعاً بدأ يتذوق, to taste it. And then I am liking it, Hassan. I am liking it.
يعني أنا مقبل إني أحبه يعني.
So it's in the process of, you got my point.
Yes, he's still in the process.
Yeah, it's a real example to show how this context is real. But it could happen. It could happen. So still, we have four differences between stative sentences and event-event sentences. So they sound natural, they seem natural, appear to be natural when they are passivized, when they are used with verb to be and ing form in the progressive or continuous. When they are used in the imperative structure and with certain adverbs like deliberately or intentionally or and so on. You see these certain adverbs? And I say I ate the fish intentionally or I broke the cup of أنت كسرت بالعاني deliberately. لكن ما اعرفش ما اقدرش اقول I know him deliberately or I knew him deliberately. So you see the difference between stative and eventive?
Yes, doctor.
There is some difference. So the stative sentences seem peculiar if not ungrammatical or anomalous. عشان كده احيانا في المدرسه استاذ ابو طارق هيبقى بنحط غلط على is liking روح if not grammatical المنهج هيك بيقول وبنعلم زي الناس.
Yes, doctor. I think I have a point here, doctor.
Go ahead, ابو طارق.
I think event verbs
indicate.
لسه درستها قبل اسبوعين يا دكتور مالها.
I think دكتور event verbs implies mobility.
خلينا أعلق على كلامك بس كمان شوي. نحن فرصة لبطار.
انفضحنا هيك.
Yes, yes, دكتور. I think event verbs implies mobility.
So even I had an action. Yes. So we have some action.
I think we have dynamic verbs.
طبعا ممكن لها اسماء اخرى. الاخت اللي بتقول اتفضحنا ولا ما عرفتش ايش. Language is not rigid or there is, فاكرين الجمله هذه تقول there is nothing called language if there is no flexibility.
Yes, thanks
to... لا يوجد ما يسمى باللغه ان لم تكن هناك مرونه. سواء لو انا بدي اسرع شويه كده ولا انا ابو احمد بحب يعني يضيع وقت. So when we teach at school, sometimes we say always usually often are used with the verbs in the simple present. Is it Quran? Is it something that what about?
No, we can use them
when I was a child. I usually played in the street. إيش المشكلة في usually مع ماضي بسيط؟ لكن كون المنهج وبساطة الأولاد وبنقول لهم الإس وبنحط لها لو بنجمعه ذا ولا مش غلط. أنا أتكلم لو بدأ أسمعك الآن كلام صغير while نسمع مع بعض الجملتين الصغار while أو دير بالك هذا اللي في الامتحان بتاع تانية سنة ولا أولى إعدادي ولا تالتة إعدادي. While I was reading the phone rang. كأنه ما فيش في الدنيا إلا الجملة ولا الفعلين هذول. While I was reading the phone rang. هم شايفين was ومع الـ ING ويا أولاد ويا بنات ويا شطرات ويا حلوات. طيب يعني ما ينفعش نقول while I was
هم بس يحفظوها يا دكتور.
هي بتريح نفسيا هي الجملة.
While I was
قول عنه
While I was reading, my mother was cooking. بنفع؟
Yes.
Why not? So both now both the clue both parts of the sentence both included are in part of the sentence. خلينا سمعك الجملة هذه. While I am sitting. You are مثلا نقول لي قاعد some students are standing while I am sitting. Why not? So language is flexible. But when we teach a rule, يعني كنت في أمريكا وفي كاليفورنيا وكنت ورحت مش عارف أحد الأمريكان وأستاذ معنا كنت أعلم في جامعة كاليفورنيا في المعهد الإنجليزي American English Institute. كنا بنتكلم على سي اي ام سي لا احنا علمناها في غزه اي كان سي ممنوع اي ام سي صار يضحك ومش يسمنا. You got my point. So I am seeing a plane now. I am seeing a plane. Why not?
يعني بنفع.
بس ما نعلموش للاولاد الصغار عشان
اكيد عشانهم صغار
عشان ناكل رزقنا وعيشنا يعني. بس الكتاب بيقول هيك الاستاذ هيك واحنا بنعلم من الامتحان الامتحان هيجي من الوزاره والوزاره بتوجيه الكلام واضح يعني sometimes we teach to the test but language is flexible. تفضل احكي وسلم.
هلا احنا نعتبر افعال مثل think and listen
now تاخذي بالك اللي بنعلمه في المدرسه مش كله غلط ولا كله صح ولا الان انا بتكلم think has two meanings could mean as
like
الاعتقاد والتفكير او ممكن or to have this process of so التفكير so I am thinking about my children ممكن I am thinking about the problem so why not use it an ing but not I think she is a genius بين فاشل I am thinking أنا بعتبرها ungrammatical American British and so I am thinking she is a she is a genius or she is beautiful or think is a stative and never is never used in ing form progressive. Some stative verbs are rarely or very rarely used progressively. موجود. موجود. Okay, let's move on. So the preceding question mark indicates strangeness. إذا نتعلم برضو علامات الاستفهام والنجم وماذا تعني. We learned some. خلاص هذا السلايد بكفية. So this example show another way in which syntax and semantics interaction. So إذا في مواضيع interaction or interrelation between syntax and semantics. Pronouns and coreferentiality, موضوع يعني بعوز له 10 دقائق عشان نختم إن شاء الله سريع كده. Now, when we talked about pronouns, we learned that there are of different types. Personal, demonstrative, relative, indefinite, and so on. We have different interrogative, فكري. ويجينا أظن سؤال في الكوز الأول. And sometimes we have the personal pronouns divided into subject, object, possessive, and we have reflexive and so on. Now coreferentiality, what do you mean by coreferentiality?
Coreferentiality.
To refer to the same item.
We have two reference for the same item or object or entity.
لازم تكون دقيقة في الكلام. So if a sentence has coreferentiality, بمعنى
two phrases refer to the same entity.
Refer to the same object or the same person.
Yes. When two utterances or phrases refer to the same object.
أجمل أمثلة ممكن تكون في in reflexive structures. So Jane bit herself. So when we say Jane bit herself, we have coreferentiality. What does it mean now? Now the word Jane. أنا بتكلم اسمع معي. The word Jane. مش this person Jane. The word Jane and the word herself refer to the same person. This is what we mean by coreferentiality. So Jane referred to this girl and herself refers to the same person. So when we say now we have coreferentiality in this sentence, بمعنى two words or parts in the sentence refer to the same person or the same thing. Okay? Amen? So the meaning of a reflexive pronoun always refers back to some antecedent. لأن نتكلم على يعني the terminology. The antecedent of herself. The antecedent of herself is Jane. You see what I mean by antecedent and coreferential and reflexive and so on. These terms must be learned and you need to know the difference. Herself refers to Jane. So Jane is the antecedent of Jane. Okay. Syntactically, reflexive pronouns and their antecedents must occur within the same is in the phrase structure rule. Or three. So what does this mean? لو سألك الآن ماذا يعني هذا الكلام؟ خلينا نشرح جملة جين بيت هرسل. واللي سأل عنها أبو طارق المرة الماضية وقال جين is an agent and herself is theme. تمام. But now we need to know something important. Sometimes we have a tree diagram like this one, a noun phrase and verb phrase, and then we have a proper noun, Jane, and we have verb, bit and herself, the pronoun, a noun phrase, لازم في الأول نكتب هيك, a noun phrase لازم هيك نكتب, a noun phrase, then pronoun, then herself. Now to say that they must be in the same level, the same is, إذن this is the same as. هتوضع النقطة الكلام هذا just in a few moments لما نشوف sometimes we have an is under another is. أحيانا بتكون جملة تحت جملة or a clause under another clause or inserted in a sentence. Let's see. Jane bit herself is a good sentence. But what about Jane said that herself slept? أنا بعت لك سؤال أو سألت لك قلت لك why is this sentence ill-formed or ungrammatical? لأن الكلام بمصطلحات علمية تخدم مساقنا. What's the problem with this sentence?
Yes. Yes, doctor.
تفضل يا احمد لولو, انا ما سمعت صوتك اليوم. احمد
معتصم من سويتين.
عاوز احمد هنا.
احمد is trying to reconnect يا دكتور. He has a problem in connection يا دكتور.
طيب عبد الكريم, في عمر صلاح, عمر صلاح موجود؟
يا دكتور موجود.
تفضل, ممكن تشرح لي يعني واتس ذا بروبلم؟ وانا بعت لك ويعني المفروض اقول واجب يسلم, والاسئله الثمانيه المفروض اسمع تكون بعت لي اجابات عشان المره الجايه حسوي الكلام هذا, لانه في ناس اللي بخافش بخوفش, لازم تخاف. جين سيد ذات هير سيلف سلام, واتس ذا بروبلم؟
يس
تفضل.
مين معتصم احكي ولا عمر؟
عمر.
اوكي اوكي,
لو الان سالتك why is sentence one correct هتكون تمام. اللي عملناه قبل شويه ده دايجرام, it is fine, واللي ممكن نشطح ونتكلم لحالها جوان نمبر 1 محاضره كامله ونتكلم على كلام كثير ونقول جين is a proper noun and it refers to a girl and we have it as a subject and we have it as a verb and Jane is with reference or with
sorry
شوية كده بس. Jane as a subject is an agent because now the verb bit requires an agent, a subject, and then bit as a verb requires a theme as an object. And now this theme or this word is a reflexive pronoun, and it is now in, again with this idea of feminine, the same as Jane, and we have it in the same is or tree. So it's fine. It's fine following the principle of compositionality, following the rules of syntax, following the rules of semantics, theta rules or theta rules and so on. But now what about sentence two?
Yes, doctor.
Faddal, ya Omar.
Sorry, doctor, but I'm...
عبد الكريم كان عايز
معتصم. ماشي معتصم, ربنا يشفيك معتصم.
Yes, this sentence is wrong because it is it has actually two sentences. The sentence that her self-slip missing a antecedent or subject. The antecedent, the antecedents, there must be an antecedent.
Sorry, guys. Sorry. Please repeat what you have said. Sorry for this.
Again, Jane said that her self-slip. This sentence is divided into two sentences. So the
so we have sentence, upper, we have upper and we have lower. We have upper S and we have lower S.
The lower S must include an antecedent for the inflexive pronoun herself. So before herself, there must be a subject that that represents the antecedent for the reflexive pronoun. So without this antecedent, is wrong. So she should say, for example, Jane said that I myself slept. So this is this way the sentence will be correct grammatically.
In fact, your material gives us two problems, two main problems. طبعا بالمناسبة ما نقلقش كتير بالديجراما. So sometimes different references, different books use different diagramming. طبعا هذا الكلام ما بيقلقش كتير. يعني لو احنا شطبناه وحطينا هنا الماضي من بايت بيت ما فيش مشكلة. تزدوجش حالك. يعني بعض الكتب بتحط ال auxiliary as a node كخط كده مستقل. But forget about it. موضوعنا الآن we have two problems in sentence two.
Yes, doctor.
قبل شوية كنا بنقول the reflexive pronoun must be in the same S rooted tree with its antecedent. إذن يجب أن يكون في مستوى واحدة في جزئية واحدة من نفسها. So here we have two different levels. Now Jane, خلينا ننظر للجملة اللي على اليمين هذه diagram. So Jane is in this S, under this S. But we have S, this is S1, خلينا نقول S1, or the upper S. And we have lower S, S2. So now herself here is in a different level. So this is a wrong. This is a problem. This is incorrect. So لو سألناك في امتحان أو quiz, why? So you need to say that both the reflexive and the antecedent or its antecedent are in different levels or not in the same is rooted tree. هيك الكتابنا بيقول.
في سبب ثاني.
This is one problem. The second problem is that
now. Can I answer?
Now the second problem is that this is has the same thing is we have NP a subject and we have a VP sleep or slip. But now in English or any other language, reflexive pronouns never fill the subject position. Never, never use a subject a reflexive in the subject position. These are the two problems in this sentence. So again, we have two problems. Sentence one is wonderful, it's fine. In terms of structure, we have herself and Jane as antecedent within the same S, within the same S rooted tree. But in sentence two, we have Jane as the antecedent of herself in two different levels. In two different levels, and this is one problem. And the second problem is that the subject position in the sentence number two or lower sentence is filled with a reflexive. This is incorrect or wrong. الكلام في كتابك وهيو أنا نسخ ولاصقه. We have this idea of correferentiality حكينا فيها. Herself and Jane refer to the same girl اللي اسمها ومشعرات ولا حلو. We have here Jean as a word and herself as a word reflexive pronoun refer to the same person. This is what we mean by co-referentiality. But about number two, here we have number one, Jane and herself, this is problem number one. Jane and herself are in different S-rooted trees. S-rooted trees. So here we have S-rooted one, a tree one, and this is S-rooted, or this is the second. So one and two. Different S-rooted trees. Cannot be co-referential. One condition on reflexive, they must be used or appear in the same level in order to have co-referentiality. إذا بدنا نقول co-referentiality, we need to have the same level of the reflexive and its antecedent. Now, the second problem is that in terms of syntax, pronouns are not, so reflexive pronouns don't fill the subject position. So syntactic and semantic rules do not allow reflexive pronouns to be subjects. To be subjects. وهذا الكلام اللي تسببت النكتة الموجودة the cartoons. So here I thought I asked you to clean up after yourself. بعد ما تنظف حالك نظف المكان. لك عملها I. But myself needed using it as a subject. Nowhere. To make fun, to create humor, and to use semantics and linguistics. I love it. Now, more examples of pronouns and co-referentiality. We have John believes that he is a genius. We have two possible interpretations of this sentence. What are they? ما هي احتمالات معنى الجملة هذه? One meaning is that he and John are co-referential, بمعنى referring to the same person. أنه أنا أبو الريف. So John believes that he is a genius. So co-referentiality. This is one meaning. The second meaning is that John as someone, a person, believes that someone else, ممكن أبو محمود ولا فلان سمير محمود عادلة. So different, totally different meaning. جون يعتقد أن فلان أنه يعني مش هو نفسه. So these are the two possible meanings. And now the second meaning doesn't involve co-referentiality. بمعنى we are thinking of two different people. John refers to someone and he refers to someone else. And the sentence is grammatical. It is possible to have a pronoun coming later and having its antecedent, so to have it now co-referentiality, or to have he referring to some other person. So can be, I will interpret it as John, هذا واحد, or as some other person other than John. Two meanings, they're ambiguous. So this sentence can be considered as ambiguous. تمام? We need more context to disambiguate it. سمعيني أخوان وخواتنا? الهدوء الغير عادي.
تمام يا دكتور
تمام. Now the second, أشكركم جميعا. He believes that John is a genius. الآن ترتيب الكلمات تغير. Now, is this sentence ambiguous? No. This sentence is not ambiguous. Now, the core franchise meaning is doesn't exist. And then, لا يمكن بالمطلق. We never think that he and John refer to the same person. مستحيل. المعنى في التركيب هذا بالسياق هذا بتأخر الاسم بعد الضمير لا يفيد أن هي وجون هما نفس الشخص. هو يعتقد أن جون إذن لا يعتقد أنه هو يعتقد أن جون إذن جون شخص آخر. So he and John are two different people and لو جبنا لك في الكوزلة كده they have a core referentiality. No, they don't have core referentiality. Because they refer to two different people. Their reference or extension is different, not the same. The core referential interpretation is impossible. مستحيل. طيب جملة ثالثة طبعا التفسير John and he cannot refer to the same person. No correlation. جملة ثالثة The fact that he is considered a genius bothers John. Is it an ambiguous sentence? Yes, it is an ambiguous sentence. طب ما هي الضمير قبل ال listen في التركيب هذا The fact that حقيقة أنه يعتبر عبقري تزعجه أنا ولا عبقري ولا حاجة أنا رجل بسيط أنا لا بعرف ولا بتاع So the fact that he is considered a genius bothers John John هو اللي يعتبر وهذا شيء يزعجه This is one meaning But it could be again another way So he and John could be referential One meaning and the other meaning is that they refer to different people. حقيقة أنه يعتقد يعني جون اللي أنه يعتبر يزعجه يزعج جون قد يكون هو نفس الشخص والمعنى الآخر أن من يعتبر هو شخص غير الذي هو يزعج به بعض الأشياء. So the pronoun he And John can be interpreted as correlation. Can be. No, can, but not necessarily. يعني we may have different possibilities. تفضل.
طب بحال إنه هما correlation. وين the ambiguity?
Here, if we have correlationality, هذا معنى. أن so. يعني نقول مثلا خلينا انا اوضح لك so he and John refer to the same person by John اذا حقيقه ان جون يعتبر عبقريا شيء يزعج جون هذا معنى so we have correlationality the second meaning is that the fact that Samir is considered a genius bothers John مثلا من وين له العبقرية سمير هذا؟ Get my point. So he could refer to someone or some person other than John. قد يكون سمير أو محمود أو هاني أو علي. واضح؟ يا جماعة. فضل.
دكتور هذه جملة واحدة. The fact that he is considered genius brothers John.
Yes, this is a complex sentence.
With the brothers,
brothers, brothers, مش brother.
Brothers.
Brothers. Now, we have two clauses. وهي الرسمة. We have two clauses. This is a complex sentence. A noun clause as a subject and then the verb and its object. إذن حقيقة أنه يعتبر عبقري أمر أو شيء يزعج تمام؟ The last, I think, John, Jane said that Bill bit herself. ممكن نفسره بنفس الطريقة. لماذا, why is this sentence infant? Why? So, we have a problem in the position of the reflexive, not in the same S, rooted level, or tree. So herself نازل تحت وجين فوق وممكن ترسم لها رسمة وحلوة. And so we have a problem. So the only possible reference for herself is not in the same S rooted tree. طب نرسمها herself when into when السجن. Two different levels. A final thought, آخر حاجة وبكفي يا أبو أحمد.
Doctor, in general, the previous sentence is wrong.
Yes. Yes.
It sounds logically to me. I don't know.
Logical? Logical?
Logical.
لكن في
self-referential.
في سر في قواعد اللغة. The reflexive pronoun. Reflexive pronoun must be in the same s with its antecedent. ولو انا رسمتها هيكونوا بعاد عن بعض, هيجين هنا ان بي.
I mean herself is antecedent for Bill.
For Jane بس بعيدة.
For
verb phrase.
So Bill is the one who bit herself, not Jane.
It should be his self.
أنا الآن ممكن في امتحان انت هيك بتبيع امتحانات. أم معتصم بيحكي؟
يس معتصم.
أنا معتصم. خلينا نسخها عشان أشوفها. معتصم.
You mean Bill is a name for a male?
A male, yes.
I see now the problem.
So now
a male, not a female.
Now different ways to fix it. عشان ممكن عيان بعد what is the problem and use the terminology of our course and also how to fix it, to correct it or to rewrite it corrected. So what
we bit himself.
So said that Bill met
himself.
Okay, very well. So now using a pronoun as an object, but a personal pronoun as an object, a position, but not a reflexive position. So herself. So herself. ممكن هذا حل. حل ثاني.
Making it himself.
Himself. Very good. Himself. So we have here himself. تمام. The final thought of our lecture. We have interaction between syntax and semantics. إذن عشان كبر المدارك والمفاهيم والأفق. In order to know a language, we have things that are not, so we have different things required. So to know about the meanings of words, كلمنا, lexicology. And to know principle of what, of compositionality, we talk about now how words are combined. And sometimes we have interaction between now rules of syntax and rules of semantics. You remember interaction, we learned different, we discussed different issues related to the interaction of syntax and semantics. تداخل علم التراكيب مع علم الدلالة موضوع شيق وممكن يعني يكون بحث ويناقش جزئية من أجزاء كثيرة. So syntax and semantics interrelate in complex ways. And that sentence structure is a crucial, is an التركيب لازم ناخد بالنا منه. Knowing a language والمحصلة is knowing the syntactic structures and the semantic rules and how they interact. عشان نتقن اللغة. In order to master a language, we need all these entities. أنا بكتفي كده ونتوقف التسجيل ونقول سبحانك الله وبحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا الله نشهد أن لا إله إلا الله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. طبعا تصبح على خير. لا احنا هنتوقف دقائق ونصلي العشاء ونرجع تاني ان شاء الله لحضور او لمشاهده the four presentations ان شاء الله.